Hello, I'm Simon Whistler. You're watching Today I Found Out, and in the video today we're looking at the curious case of spider rain. Worryingly described by entomologists and arachnologists as a not uncommon occurrence in certain parts of the globe, spider rain can see anywhere from a few thousand to several million spiders tumble from the sky in a given area, seemingly out of nowhere. So what causes this bizarre phenomenon? Well, this is thanks to a rather interesting behavior exhibited by spiders, which is known as ballooning. Essentially, this involves an individual spider climbing to a high point and then firing strands of silk into the air, with the result being that the spider is carried away by the wind, sometimes for many hundreds of miles. Arachnologists are quick to point out that countless spiders are probably flying around overhead at any particular time, and that they usually land without much fanfare and go about their way. Sometimes, though, many thousands or millions of spiders will decide to balloon at exactly the same time, either because they're a single colony or because weather conditions force them to. In regards to the latter, on rare occasions, certain weather patterns can see the millions of spiders floating through the air at any given time being thrown to Earth simultaneously at the exact same location. Other known causes of spider rain are floods and wildfires, which can prompt spiders to flee en masse to escape what would otherwise be their demise. This rather concerningly illustrates the fact that the old kill it with fire way of getting rid of spiders is not totally foolproof. As an example of the former flood trigger phenomenon in Pakistan following devastating floods throughout the country in 2010, millions of spiders got out of there in a hurry via mass ballooning. While you'd expect the people of Pakistan to be unhappy about having to deal with both millions of spiders raining from the sky as well as the floods, the spiders were actually seen as a good thing by most citizens because they ate the mosquitoes. On that note, in addition to ensuring the skies remain free of disease-carrying insects, wandering clouds of spiders also provide ample food for birds and other creatures, a fact that, combined with spiders often being amongst the first creatures to return to land devastated by flood and fire via ballooning and landing back in the area, means that spider rain is generally seen as being an overall beneficial thing for nature via allowing these staples of the food chain to quickly and widely disperse themselves. While you can observe individual spiders floating about in most regions of the Earth, if you're wanting to see the specific phenomenon of spider rain, where millions of spiders fall from above en masse, your best bet is to live in certain regions of Australia, because, well, of course it's Australia. As New South Wales resident Keith Basterfield states, "They fly through the sky and then we see these falls of spiderwebs that almost look as if it's snowing." Luckily for arachnophobes, mass ballooning is a behavior near exclusively observed in smaller species of spider, or ones that were born very recently, as larger spiders are simply too heavy to be carried along by typical winds. As a result, if you're currently imagining endless waves of tarantulas raining from the sky, you can rest assured that if you ever witness spider rain firsthand, at least you won't be dealing with big spiders, just the little ones that can crawl around on you without you even noticing they're there. This is also significant because most small spiders don't possess the ability to penetrate human skin with their bites, even if they are otherwise highly venomous. Thus, for the most part, spider rain is totally harmless to humans. However, the phenomenon can potentially damage crops when millions of spiders all land in the same location, with their subsequent webs cutting the plants off from enough sunlight. But I think here the main point that I want to drive home to arachnophobes is that some spiders can fly, and at any given time, they might just fall out of the sky and onto your head. So I really hope you found that video enjoyable. If you did, please do hit that thumbs up button below, and do not forget to subscribe. We've got brand new videos just like this every day of the week. Also, if you'd like to support us in doing that, in making videos every day of the week, please consider supporting us on Patreon. You can find a link to that in the description below. And as always, thank you for watching.